you want.
Project.
This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want. 1600 block. I just wanna rock. I just wanna. I just wanna rock. Body out of ya. Shorty got that body out of ya. Hit it once, no time. Side up. You gon' kill my vibe. Stand on my money, don't know my size. Pick them sides. And you better choose wisely. That's my high. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Welcome to Cruiser News. And my name is Amelia. And with me is.
Naver.
We have a lot to show you today, so let's hop right into it. Nana and Navier interviewed a staff member. Let's see who they chose and learn more about this person.
All right, today I'm here with
Mr. Bergman.
What's up, Mr. Bergman? I got a couple questions for you, all right?
Okay.
All right. So my first question is, why did you get into teaching and like why here?
Okay, so I got into teaching, so I wanted to do a job where I was with people. I didn't want to be in like a cubicle, where I just didn't get to interact. I wanted to be with people in a way where I got to work with them and help them. I ended up in math, because I thought there'd be jobs in math. And I ended up in Groveport, so I grew up in Columbus. And I knew there was a job opening here. I applied, I knew a new school was coming, I was still at the old school. And they hired me. I liked it enough, I've been here for 6 years now.
What's your favorite part of your job?
Favorite part of my job would be, getting to interact with people and getting involved in people's lives. Either that's talking to them about their personal life or talking to them about the school, like helping them to get like priorities straight. You guys want to help the people around me, you know? So whether that's a student that, you know, needs help with a specific thing, or it's a coworker that wants to talk about life. Like, I'm here to be with people.
If you weren't a teacher right now, what would you be doing?
Like a job that, if I could pick any job or a job I think I could get.
Any job at all.
For me, if I was you, I'd say a basketball player because you are quite tall.
I mean, NBA would be great.
That would be.
I mean, if I could be in NBA, that would probably be it. But I don't think I was ever really meant for that, you know? I'd probably pick. I'm trying to think of something where. What's something where you're really with people? You get a lot of interaction.
Kind of social worker?
But you're paid really well. I don't know.
A lot of people.
I can
see. Have to be rich.
I can see myself just being like, honestly. And a thing like an outdoor program where you're just like with people outside, you get to like tell them about nature and walk around. My siblings are real into that. I don't know anything about nature, but it sounds nice to be outside and talking with people.
Alright. Final question of the day, young one. How long did it take you to grow that little big old beard?
I mean, I haven't shaved in about 2 years now completely. But I trimmed it up for a wedding about a month ago, but I think if I started fresh, I could get to this in about 4 months.
Jesus.
Maybe.
All right, Mr. Bergman. That was all we have for you today.
This week in Cruiser Takes, Amaya, Braylon, and Malachi took on a task. Let's check out what they did.
This is TikTok dance.
Oh, you bad girl. I'm a savage. Yeah. Classy, bougie, ratchet. Yeah. Sassy, moody.
Here we go. Cute face. Fat. Jump in my jeans. Jump in my bag.
Pillow. Got another shorty. She ain't nothing like me. Yeah. Got to crush another fight. Bottom, make him wanna bite. I just wanna have a good night. I just wanna have a good night.
Yeah, she kind of like, hold on. She tried to fuck all of my trap phone.
We interviewed Alex, who participated in Model UN this year, with Mr. Mertz. Let's find out how they did.
So, OMUN is always really fun to do.
You go to the Hyatt Hotel in Columbus, and actually this time there was a con going on at the exact same time. That was quite interesting. But you are there for 3 days, and what ends up happening is for the first day you're in a small group councils with about, I think it was like 5 or 6 other countries, and you present your case there. And then you move on to a human rights council or a general assembly, which my group Somalia made into the general assembly. And in that, you speak to every single one of the countries that is in the room. In the Human Rights Council, you talk to about 30 of them, I'd guess. And it's overall just a very good experience. It's fun to sit there and debate with people about whether something is good or bad to implement. And everyone there is just always super nice.
I feel it. And did you like this experience, or did you like just being there in the first place?
Yeah, it's always fun to just go there. It's a beautiful view most of the time. And also, it's just genuinely a good experience to have and something good to put on a resume, first off. And second off, it's always nice to see people like Amina, for example, won Best Delegate. It's nice to sit there and watch people you know succeed. And it's nerve-wracking, exciting to be able to try and solve the world's issues to other people of your generation.
Right, right. All right, well, that's all we have for you today, Alex. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Every year, there is a blood drive, and multiple students and staff participate in making it successful. Let's check it out.
That you were doing a blood drive this year. Mm-hmm. What are you guys doing, and who are you doing it for?
So the National Honor Society, which I am the advisor for, they are partnering with the American Red Cross to put on a blood drive on Friday the 20th. We'll be having a blood drive from 8 to 2 in the auditorium, where people, we've actually had all of our appointment slots filled up, but if people want to go in either during their lunch, or if you're a teacher during your conference period, to go donate, they can.
All right, how many times a year do you do a blood drive?
We aim for about 3 a year. Unfortunately, we weren't able to do our one in fall, but we have this one, obviously, that we're doing on Friday, and then we'll have another one either in April or May.
All right, what can donors expect when giving blood?
So at first, they go through a series of medical questions just to make sure it's safe that you donate. They will go through and do a check of your iron content to make sure you have the necessary iron levels to donate. If you're a little unsure of what your iron levels are, you can always eat some red meat or spinach the night before to try and make sure you have a really high iron content. And then if you are eligible to donate, they'll go ahead and they'll have a needle that they'll put into your arm either here or here, and they'll take about a pint of blood from you.
All right. How is this blood drive different from ones that you did last year?
So this year we've decided to really up the ante to really thank the people who are able to donate. So we have 2 different raffle events going on. We have one for a lunch with Mr. Altman and one for a $25 gift card to Canes for anyone who's able to go and try to donate.
All right.
You
have
any questions?
No, that was good. All right.
Thank you, Mr. Anytime. Thank you, guys.
This week, Awa, M, and Sergio interviewed Coach Hampton for Athlete of the Week. Let's see who the coach chose.
Today we're here with
Coach Gene Padgett.
And the question is, who's the Athlete of the Week?
For our freshman class, 2026, freshman of the week would be Tyrese Simpson.
And why?
Over the last couple of games, he's just been a big-time leader. He stepped into the role as a point guard and been an extension of myself, which is the coach. And in his last game, he had a big-time performance. Had like 24 points and maybe 5 three-pointers. So that definitely was a big transition for him. Hopefully, I can continue to see him grow and put performances like that together. Often.
What are you excited for during the end of the season?
I'm excited to see all the guys get better. I have a lot of guys that's been moved up from freshman to JV, so you can definitely see the development of those guys, and hopefully they can continue to develop, continue to prepare themselves to help, turn this into a winning culture at Grove Point.
Anything else you want to share?
It's great to be a cruiser.
Thank you. Today we're here with
Coach Hampton, boys varsity basketball head coach.
And the question is, who's the athlete of the week, JV and varsity?
Kamar Keys is JV, and Tariq Ruffin is the varsity.
And why?
They were our leading scorers in the Bradley game.
What are you excited for during this season?
I'm excited about our team developing. We're a very young team. I'm just excited about how they're going to turn out towards the end of the season for our tournament run.
Anything else you want to share with us?
I would love for more people to come out and support the team on our home games. It really will help out the program.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
And now for the daily announcements. GMS cheer competition team will compete in Buckeye Cheer Open Nationals downtown at the Convention Center this Sunday at 10 a.m.
If you ordered a yearbook within the last 2 years, please stop by the downstairs office and pick it up. From Mrs. Gibbs.
If you are interested in competing with other schools and our esports program, swing by room 161 after school on Tuesdays and Wednesdays from 2:30 to 4 o'clock. We are looking for Smash Bros, Fortnite, and Overwatch players.
Diversity Community will have our first meeting of 2023 on Tuesday, January 31st, 2023, in room 225. Please bring ideas for Black History Month and Women's History Month. Spanish Club will meet in room 150 at 2:30 p.m. on Monday, January 23rd. All students and staff are welcome.
And that's it for Cruiser News. Have a great end to the weekend.
This ain't what you want.
Project.
This ain't what you want. This ain't what you want. 1600 block. I just wanna rock. I just wanna rock.